please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Bazaar Morning Call, live from the CNBC TV18 headquarters in Mumbai.
We feel that it will be normal to above normal category scenario is more likely to happen, and the possibility of deficit we have clearly ruled it out, and that's how we said it will be 97 plus minus 5%.
Well, good morning. Welcome to Bazaar Morning Call. I'm Lata and with me Anuj and Sonia, and that's about the pleasantest sight, isn't it? The sight of rain when we are getting roasted in scorching heat. That might add, bring those blessings to the stock markets as well. Yesterday, we already saw the likes of Escorts and VST Tillers up among the gainers. So it was expected that things will not be adverse. But now the news has come in well and truly. So looks like that's going to be one big positive for the Indian markets today. A second positive actually is the global markets. We've seen a bit of recovery in Asian markets after the Chinese GDP number came in a little better than expected at 6.8% versus a Reuters poll of 6.7%. So therefore, are we going to, we are already at the higher end of the Nifty's new range. Should we knock over and pole vault beyond 10,600 is the question the markets will be answering today. Now, on the other hand, I just want to put a couple of negatives on the table. Yesterday, after markets closed and after we got the, IMD forecast, the rupee weakened. It was all the while at 65.36. It was already a weak day for the rupee. It weakened all the way to 65.49, almost 65.50. That's like a five-month low. As well, the bond yields, which were fairly robust at 7.43 because of some very positive news, auction news on Friday, it weakened all the way to 7.49. Now, all this happened after 3:30. So I just want to put that on the table. There is otherwise very positive news, but will this spoil the party? Morning, both of you.
Hi, good morning. Well, after the good news that we got from the monsoons yesterday, I guess a lot of people preempted that, right? We saw all the monsoon-related stocks rally, whether it was the two-wheeler names, Escorts, the tractor names, M&M, Escorts, etc. So, of course, it is a good news, but how much of it is already in the price, you'll get to know today. Anuj, morning. 8 straight days of gains. We missed you yesterday, by the way, because, the market had a mind of its own. It moved through the course of the day, ended at the high point. But do you think that at this stage, after 8 days of gains, we're perhaps ripe for a bit of consolidation?
Morning, Sonia. I miss being here as well. On Friday, we had made this point that 10,427 all through last week was a big resistance. Once that was taken out, it was logical for the market to move on towards 10,600. Now, what the market has done is it's recovered 50% of the overall correction from 11,100 to 10,000. It's now recovered 50%. So, you normally see 50 to 66% as the retracement zone. Now, what happens is, very simple, you have to buy the dips. Even yesterday, I think the market gave you a dip for global reasons. And if you bought that, you made money. 10,427 is your sacrosanct stop now. If for any reason the market gives you a dip and slips below, say, 10,500, don't chase momentum in this market, because that may not work on an intraday basis. Positionally, of course, that's working. On Bank Nifty, perhaps you have to wait for 100-150 point dip if for any reason that comes. And you've got a beautiful sacrosanct sort of support here. 25,050 has been the low for last 2 or 3 days. Is also just above the 200-day moving average. Every time the market is dipping, this level is acting as a massive support. So not worth chasing momentum, perhaps buy the dips. Also, there's this one point that, we've been making all through last 2 months. TCS has come back. And, TCS went through a period where there was, because of that promoter selling, there was that overhang. And once that was over, the way TCS has rallied, and IT really is the leader of this market, has been for some time now, Infosys notwithstanding. So with TCS making a comeback, bank stocks, banking index finding its mojo, April at least looks like, is going to be one of those series where, you just make a one-way move. Perhaps, in May you have something different, but in this month, the trend is very clear. You have to buy all dips because market is rewarding you if you're buying that.
No, no, actually, even I was not very sure whether I should put the rupee fall in the negative class at all. Because actually, it might turn out to be a big stock market positive. It usually does for most stock markets. And for us, we have a direct correlation with TCS. Yesterday, the IT stocks actually followed Infosys. And kind of, they all smoldered under the pain of Infosys, as it were, as if a subpar margin from Infosys is an indication that all IT stocks, they did not take advantage of the weakness in the rupee. But today might well be the day when they will shake off the Infosys gloom, considering that Infosys itself actually recovered a bit from the low. And the other important point, which you obviously wouldn't have noticed yesterday, is yesterday at any point in the morning, if you had bought, you made money by end of day. So it was clearly an upward trending day. So that also looks like it
has been upward trending. And you know, Lata, you remember on Friday we made this point that Infosys went into earnings with very high expectations and had rallied a lot. So on Friday morning, you know, we made this point that perhaps, you know, you would see profit booking in Infosys. And essentially what you saw was just that. And the stock had moved up so much. So it was more a reaction to that than anything else in yesterday's
trade. Possible that today we could have a bit of a tailwind for the monsoon stocks, for IT stocks because of rupee. And therefore, maybe the mojo is with the bulls.
Oh, yes. And a couple of more positives, right? I mean, crude has fallen. It fell about $1.50 a barrel last night. So that's a positive for us. And we also have good cues from the globe. So the Dow also was up almost about 200 odd points. But let's kickstart the show on that note and tell you what our wise experts have to say as we head into trade this morning. Ridhim Desai of Morgan Stanley believes that the elections present tail risks, especially if the outcome counters what is priced in. Ridhim thinks that the market appears unsure of whether India will re-elect a majority government in 2019. If this uncertainty rises, Morgan Stanley thinks stocks will continue to struggle in coming months. Their bull case Sensex target for the next 12 months is 41,500 and base case target is 37,500.
You know, this negative that Ridhim is speaking about can hit us a little earlier. It's a possibility. Because the early election surveys, pre-election surveys for Karnataka, which came on Thursday, indicated not a majority for the Congress, but single largest party and therefore possibly a hung parliament. The point is it did not indicate a victory for the BJP. So that it hasn't affected the market much, but that's a headwind which in mid-May might impact the market. Ricky, just keep that in mind. Well, let's get some money market views. Bhaskar Pandey of HDFC Bank says the USD INR pair is trying to break above 65.50 per dollar on the back of widening trade deficit and a wave of protectionism swaying US. Technically, he says 64.85 is now a solid support. Given this, he expects the USD INR pair to trade in a range of 65.35-65.55 today.
Okay, and let's also take a quick look at what's happening in the bond market. Bhaskar Pandey believes that after moderate CPI data, the WPI data released yesterday has confirmed a soft inflation bias. Bhaskar believes that the 10-year benchmark bond yield may trade within 7.45 to 7.50% range for the day.
Okay, over to Nigel then for the world view.
Well, the U.S. markets, they had a big run overnight. The Dow, in fact, gained close to around 200 points. Two key reasons why we saw a rally: the Syrian fears, that eased off a tad bit. And the second factor was the earnings that came out yesterday. That came in a tad bit better than what the street was working with. Focusing first on the first part of news, the easing of those Syrian fears. Well, we had commentary that came in yesterday from the U.S. Secretary of Defense, James Mattis. He says that, in fact, it was a one-time shot and, in fact, it was aimed only at the Syrian government that was using chemical weapons. So that was easing of those fears. Secondly, the earnings that came yesterday looked quite good. BofA ML, in fact, came out with a set of numbers. Bank of America, in fact, and J.B. Hunt, that's the transport company, both those two stocks did well in trade. And post-market hours, we had Netflix came out with a set of numbers. That stock's going to do well today because in post-market, it's up nearly around 3 to 4%. It ended mildly in the red in yesterday's trading session. Those numbers look quite good. We had the economic data as well. We had the U.S. retail sales rose up by close to around 0.6%. That was boosted by auto sales in yesterday's trading session. Moving to the European markets, there was a red on the screen over there. In fact, all the three frontliners, they ended in the red. The big stock yesterday was WPP, the advertising agency. That was down close to around 6% on the back of news that Martin Sorrell did quit amid allegations of misconduct. Moving to the Asian markets then, well, they were lower in trade, but all of them have recovered from the low point of the day. We had the Chinese GDP that looked better than what the street was working with, so that could be a factor. The SGX Nifty at one point of time was indicating a cut of around 25 points. Now it's indicating a flattish start. Back to you.
Thank you very much, Nigel, for that. Yes, the Chinese GDP number has pulled up a lot of Asian indices, but I think India will dance to its own monsoon tunes. Yesterday, about the best news that the country waits for and got was that the monsoon this year would be 97% of its long-term average. We have Mr. D.S. Pai, the director of the India Met Department, joining us on the phone line. Mr. Pai, I know you all had an exhaustive press conference yesterday and we heard every word of it. But just to reconfirm, what is the forecast? The forecast is we will get 97% of the long-term rains. Is there any further number as to how sure you are of it? Is this a 60% bet, a 70% bet? Anything in terms of how strong is this opinion?
See, generally, years when you have got the signals from Pacific and Indian Ocean is weak, the predictability is not so strong. Mm. And even this year also, as we had said, from the Pacific, the signal is showing neutral conditions. Mm. And from Indian Ocean, it's a weak negative IOD. So the net effect is 97%. But we can say that, since you have said, maybe around 60% sure we can.
Okay. So you're 60% sure about this forecast. So, you did also mention at the press conference that the region-wide forecast will be given in the month of June. However, I wanted to understand from you, Mr. Pai, that what are the preliminary indications suggesting? Could the rainfall be fairly distributed across regions, especially in the south, northeast, etc.?
See, generally the forecast done during the spring season, that is the March, April, May, the skill for spatial distribution was not so good. Mm. So that's why generally we don't give a forecast in the month of April. It is kept for May end. However, from various forecasts, from various model, global models, we have got access to around 20-30 forecasts. They are all actually not converging. There is a large variation in the spatial distribution. That's why there is a lot of uncertainty.
Okay.
However, if we take net effect of all that, most of the region should get a normal rainfall. Okay. We are not finding any region with a large deficiency.
Okay.
Again, as I said, if there is any, we will come up in the month of May.
Is there any indication at all of the time-wise distribution? Can you say with any certainty how quickly the monsoons will start? Will they start at the normal time of June 1st? Will June receive normal rainfall? Is September more under threat? Any indication at all?
See, from the present features, they are not indicating any delay in the monsoon.
Okay.
But however, close to monsoon, generally when synoptic systems like low pressure, depression, etc. form, they may shift onset by 1 week here and there. Mm. So that's why 1 month before or 2 months before onset over Kerala is not possible. So we will have, as of now, we can say close to normal, but exact forecast will be given around the 15th of May.
Okay, Mr. Pai. Thank you very much for reiterating and clarifying our doubts. So there's a 60% certainty of India getting a 97% long-term average rainfall. That's more a relief than, a complete relief. It's a temporary respite for sure, considering the scorching heat. And we can't make any further. I think he was more clear about that the spatial distribution will be more or less fine. Mm.
I think also this is the first time that I've heard so much clarity in the first press conference. Generally, they don't give you so much clarity. This time they said that very low probability of a deficient monsoon, etc. So I guess they're fairly certain. But let's see how that plays out. Morning, the SGX Nifty is flat, but we've had 8 days of gains under our belt. So let's see whether there's any consolidation that plays out today. Our research team is here to give you the list of top 10 stocks to watch as we get into trade today. So let's get all of them on board. Hi, guys. Morning. Anuj, what are you looking at?
So, I just mentioned it. TCS, for example, Sonia, strongest stock in the strongest sector. It's now moved within 2% of a lifetime high. And yesterday's closing was second highest closing ever for TCS. And it's, saw 650 crores of delivery buying yesterday, highest since that promoter stake sale. So It's put behind the time correction. And if you see the chart of TCS over the last 1 year, you'll know, you know, the kind of move that it's made. The other one is also a big stock, actually. Britannia has moved to its high, all-time high valuation of 50 times. Now, for me, what's interesting is it now going through the valuation re-rating? Because it's at all-time high, but now you rolled over to FY19. And in that case, you know, strong consumption stocks are going through a bit of a re-rating. In that case, let's see, it went through a consolidation between 4,500 to 5,000. After that, it's just been one-way journey on that stock. Again, not a stock where you want to chase, but, you know, dips are good buying opportunities in most of these stocks.
Okay. Well, mine are the easy set following the monsoon confirmation of 97% of the long-term average. One should expect that monsoon-related stocks will have a positive day. Definitely, you can pick up all the fertilizer stocks. UPL already has had a good day. Yesterday was a very good day for United Phosphorus, and one should see that continuing, along with all the RCFs and the NFLs, the fertilizer stocks, Tata Chemicals perhaps, and more importantly, the tractor stocks. Escorts has already had a roaring time. One should see Escorts and VST Tillers once again among the gainers. And maybe a little bit of FMCG also thrown in, because they have so much of at least 50% of their demand coming in from rural areas. Mm-hmm. So watch out for those stocks. They could well be the leaders today. But I think speaking of tractors and tillers, M&M should be on your radar too.
Yes. In fact, CLSA thinks just like you. They also have M&M on their list. They've in fact raised the target price. It's quite a bit. 960 is the target price currently. Of course, rural demand is expected to improve, but they also say that there will be a big hike in government support prices. That is likely. Also, the government, remember, the budget had announced plans to provide a minimum 50% margin to farmers. Mm. They've also provided a 20% increase in the allocation for food subsidies. All of this put together implies a 15% increase in MSP in rice this year versus an average of 5% hike in the last 5 years. So they are quite confident that all of this would give a big boost to M&M.
Okay, that's M&M, of course, a stock doing remarkably well now. 800 on that stock. Just see the 1 month chart stock, one-way rally on that one as well. But the Fortis saga continues. Ekta has some more details now.
Well, yes, the board is going to meet on this Thursday to decide between the three offers which are available to them. But additionally, there are reports indicating that IHH may in fact make a hostile bid in case the Fortis board rejects their offer on the Thursday meet. So it'll be interesting. We haven't confirmed that independently, but we expect the stock to probably be range bound to a little bit of green simply because of the kind of interest it's seeing.
But Ekta, before we let you go, congratulations. You broke the story yesterday and the Cipla stock was up 5% on your news break that the US FDA has given a green tick to one of its plants. If you could, today the company has confirmed it. So if you could elaborate on it.
Yes, and we've got the observations which were issued to the firm, to the Indore plant, Lata. So there are three observations in total. So that's a positive that there are three observations. Generally, number of observations which are lesser are easier to resolve. That's the assumption. Plus, there is no data integrity in the observations, no repeat observations. The company is confident of solving them. But I would still be a little bit cautious on the first observation, which is basically on test specifications. So maybe a little bit of caution on account of that. But because of the company's confidence, I expect follow-on buying.
Okay, follow-on buying. Huge buying yesterday. The stock was up 5.5%. Thanks, Ekta, for that. Well, more order wins coming in. Bajaj Electricals is on our radar. Anisha joins in to tell us more. Anisha?
Well, yes, the company has bagged 3,600 crore worth of orders, and this is the rural electrification orders that they have got from the government, and this is for electrification of villages and urban areas in the state of UP. Now, remember, just last week, they had bagged orders worth around 2,400 crores in a similar set of business, and it looks like the order inflows continues for the company. But I would want to know how the execution capabilities stand, because all of these projects, 5,000 crores worth of project, have to be completed over the next 15 months. How will the working capital situation pan out, and where will the company get the funds to meet these requirements is something I'll watch out for. But overall, definitely a positive news. The company has been telling that we should expect a 20% growth as far as the EPC business is concerned in FY19. Looks very likely given the short time that they have to complete all these projects in.
Okay, thank you very much. Bajaj Electricals should be important with that order. Reema, Relcom, exactly what is the news? They can't sell their fiber and their towers. They can sell everything else.
Yes, Lata. So the NCLAT ruling earlier in the month had said that Reliance Communication can go ahead and sell its tower as well as fiber business to Jio, along with the rest of the business like your real estate, etc. Yesterday, the Supreme Court has stayed this NCLAT order, which means as of now, Reliance Communication cannot sell their tower business, which is the cash cow, to Reliance Jio. The NCLAT will be hearing this case tomorrow again, where they will take into cognizance one of the issues of the minority shareholders, that's HSBC Daisy, which has about a 4% stake in Reliance Infratel. The NCLAT will also take into cognizance a settlement claim of about 4% interest to these minority shareholders. So as of now, at least, Reliance Communication cannot go ahead and proceed with the sale deed of its tower business to Reliance Jio. So a bit of a setback in the near term, but of course, more details will emerge tomorrow when the NCLAT will finally rule on it.
Okay, we'll wait for that. Thanks, Reema. Let's wrap this up now with some more stocks that are in the news this morning. Sonal, over to you.
Thanks a lot for that, Sonia. Well, Jai Bharat Maruti will be in news because it reported its Q4 numbers. A decent set of numbers, though the revenue was flat, they expanded their operating profit margins by 130 basis points. Profits came in lower by around 13%, but that was majorly because tax rate came in at 34% versus 17% year-on-year, but expect some green on that stock. Alok Industries will be in focus again today because the resolution professional has applied to the NCLT for liquidation of the company, so expect that stock to be in the red. Sobha is in focus because it has forayed into Gujarat Gift City by investing over 500 crore rupees, and the land that they'll be developing has a size of around 1.3 million square feet, and they'll be developing around 1,000 housing units, so expect some green on that stock. Gitanjali Gems will be in focus because there are reports that suggest that ICICI Bank has placed application in NCLT against Gitanjali Gems, so expect some red on that stock, but remember, we have not independently verified this news, and all these stocks will be in focus today.
Okay, so plenty of stocks to look at this morning. Thanks a lot for that, guys. Here's a quick recap now of our top stocks to watch. Expected to gain TCS, Britannia, UPL, RCF, a lot of the monsoon related stocks in the tractor space, VST Tillers, Escorts, M&M Financial, Marico, Dabur, Fortis, Bajaj Electricals, Cipla, Jai Bharat Maruti, Sobha. While stocks expected to be under pressure today, perhaps Relcom, you have Alok Industries and Gitanjali Gems.